Our next speaker has been a longtime friend of the Marathon Challenge. For the last 16 years, he has been the president and CEO of Dana-Farber. Under his guidance, Dana-Farber has been ranked the top cancer hospital in New England by U.S. News and World Report for 15 consecutive years. During his tenure, there have been significant growth in the Institute's research and patient care initiatives and in the technology and facilities necessary to support them. He has been committed to the signature total patient care envisioned by founder Sidney Farber, MD, which continues to make Dana-Farber such a special place today. When he retires at the end of this year, he will have positioned Dana-Farber to continue its upward ascent as one of the premier cancer institutes in the world. Please give a warm welcome to Dr. Edward Benz.
Well, thank you very much, Rich. I'm told that this year I have exactly a maximum of 150 seconds to speak to you, and I just wasted 10 of them telling you that. So I will simply add my profound thanks and the thanks of everyone at the Dana-Farber, and most importantly, our patients and their loved ones, to the many, many people that Rich mentioned who have been so instrumental in making this marathon a challenge and making the Claudia Adams Barr Foundation program such an astounding success. I did want to save most of those 150 seconds to tell you a quick story, because you know with incredible amount of time and effort, your fundraising, that you accomplish great things. You accomplish great things by doing the marathon. You accomplish great things by supporting our runners when they do it. You accomplish great things by raising extraordinary amounts of money that helps us to meet our mission. But the end game for all of us is better outcomes for cancer patients. And just this past week, the Food and Drug Administration approved a new drug based on an entirely new mechanism for attacking cancer, attacking a program that cancer cells use to avoid the process of auto-suicide of cells, which is what our cells usually do when they're no longer necessary. That drug began with research in the laboratory of Stan Korsmeyer with a young faculty member emerging on his own by the name of Tony Letai, who found the basic mechanisms by which this drug could be developed. The drug will now be used to treat patients with an advanced form of chronic lymphocytic leukemia, always known to have a particularly bad prognosis, and it works amazingly well in patients who've been resistant to every prior attempt at chemotherapy. The response rates are incredible. Many of these patients can go on to have a curative bone marrow transplant, and that is what you're accomplishing with your efforts. This, by the way, is the eighth, I believe, new treatment for cancer that has come into practice in the last year as a result either exclusively or primarily of Dana-Farber research. And virtually all of those drugs have your fingerprints on them because of either the direct support of our investigators or because of the platforms that support the science that you've allowed us to develop, the genomic platforms that allow us to profile patients' tumors so we can find those precise mutations to attack and give them more precise therapy. So I cannot thank you enough for all of that. It's an incredible job that you've done, and when those drugs would not be in practice, it's literally quite true without your efforts. Now, this is my last chance to address you at the pasta party. As you just heard, I'm going to be retiring later this year, and I just want to take the opportunity to thank you personally for your support of my efforts and, most importantly, of our efforts. If I had to grade myself for my tenure at Dana-Farber, I'd say that while we've accomplished some terrific things, I'd have to give myself an incomplete, because cancer is not yet cured. And anyone who comes to run a cancer center ought to make his or her goal that before his or her tenure is over, cancer should be cured. So I have to leave my job with an incomplete, But I know that through your efforts and the efforts of many more who will quite literally follow in your footsteps, cancer will be conquered. And that conquest, as I said, will have your fingerprints all over it. Thank you very, very much.
We can't let you get away without a little gift bag here. This is a little goodie bag of some of the fundraising projects to give you and your wife to remember our team.
Thank you,
thank
so,
you very
thank
much.
You so much.
Thank you, Dr. Benz.